Hello everybody, this is Frank Michael from AdaPro. Yeah, so you might have heard from our quick model challenge and yeah, I want to give you a short preview what you would expect in this session. And yeah, so let me show you how easy it is in SAP Signavio to create a quick model. So what I've done, I'm logged in here in SAP Signavio, the suite for business process management. And yeah, what have I done is I have a template in which I have made some thoughts about a process in my company, for example. So my organization is my company Inc. The start of the process is demand identified. The end is demand fulfilled, for example, yeah. And this process takes place when stock is required in an outlet store. Once it has been identified that there's a demand for more stock, it is initially established whether the demand can be fulfilled with goods already in stock. If this is the case, then the demand is fulfilled. Should the goods not be in stock, the quantity required is ascertained and the purchase order is created. So I've made some previous thoughts about my process. What is the start? What is the end? What do I want to capture? Yeah, as a process model, actually. And it's always good if you have a good imagination about what process you want to capture. Yeah, and therefore we have here some activities which I've written in this Excel. Specify and quantify the demand, which is done by whom? By a department. Yeah, this is also part of a process. And use goods from stock, for example, which is done by a department, or create a purchase requisition, which is also done by a department using an ERP system. Yeah? And what is the result? An output document is a purchase requisition, for example. Yeah, then some other activities, I've lined them here up, and also some additional information about who and IT systems and so on. Okay, now I'm prepared for my quick model challenge. Let us go to Signavio, new quick model. There we go. As you can see, a similar layout. So let's do this. My company, Inc. Yeah. I can even copy and paste here. Demand identified, demand fulfilled. And okay, let's name the process. Demand fulfillment in a store, for example. Okay, save it. Okay, I can take the documentation as well. I prepared this. There we go. Oops. Copy and pasting is not always so easy as it seems. Copy, paste. Okay, there we go. Save it. Okay, now comes the interesting part, activities. So what happens? First step, specify and quantify the demand. I do that and enter this in the field. And what happens as I press enter? Then Signavio automatically draws the first diagram. As you have seen, my company organization is taken over, also start and end, demand identified, demand fulfilled has also been drawn into this diagram, and also the first activity has been drawn by Signavio. So let's now do who department. As I see, the model is refreshed in just some seconds. Here we have a new role, department, which is called a so-called swim lane, added to the process model. Okay, next thing, use goods for stock. So now the second activity is drawn, and also automatically the department is filled out from the previous activity. Okay, next one, create purchase requisition. There we go. So who's doing this? Department as well. So that's correct. And what is the IT system? It is ERP system. So I can even create this IT system. And what does Signavio do? Add the ERP system into the process. Same with output document, purchase requisition. And so on and so on. I can even select from the glossary, for example. So there might be a glossary in the system defining some document. Yeah. And you can choose from that. So here we have it. ERP system, purchase requisition as a result. So I can go on and go on. You can imagine I don't need to complete that now, because today our challenge is to be quick, but I think you understand the thing. You say now, okay, but this process is not perfect, because either I use goods from stock or I create a purchase requisition. If I use goods from stock, then I don't need to create a purchase requisition. Well, that is true. But as we are here in quick model, this is not so much of a relevance now. We can do this in the standard editor. Because here in quick model, of course, we have quick results, but limited possibilities. But I can quickly change to the graphical editor. And here I can refine my process. Yeah? So for example, I can take an exclusive gateway. First I make some space here, for example. Do a gateway. Okay, here we go. Enough stock available ? No? Okay, so here's the answer. Yes. And demand is fulfilled, so we can even go to the direct end of the process and take these ones and move them down. Can even now format a little bit my process like this. Okay, demand is fulfilled in this case. And I have another result here, which is going this way. And then I can go on with the other rest of the process, for example. Okay. I can save that. Save. And I can even go back into quick model again. So this I find really impressive. I have this diagram, the change diagram, and I even can see this here. So now you can see how you quickly can create a process model by quick model and even go to the graphical editor to change it and edit it, give it a different shape, a little bit more logic. But the thing is, you can be very quick in this quick model, and if you want to do this, then just join our quick model challenge. You're welcome. Goodbye.